The task force for the West Philippine Sea preparing to implement a new strategy to counter China. National Security Council Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya says they're just waiting for a go signal from President Marcos. Malaya assured the public the Philippines won't back down in the face of China's bullying.
The National Task Force West Philippine Sea, as headed by Secretary Eduardo Anyo, has prepared a national strategy, a new national strategy for the West Philippine Sea, which does not only contain our military strategy, but also contains non-military strategies. And it's ready for presentation to the President. I hope we are given an opportunity to make that presentation this December, so that if the President adopts this new strategy, this could possibly signal the change that you have been asking.
The Philippine Coast Guard bears Chinese vessels deployed a water cannon against the Philippine ships 8 times. It adds, while the mission was ultimately successful, one of the Philippine vessels suffered damage and the lives of the boat crew were put in danger. PCG spokesperson for the West Philippine Sea believes it's important to publicize China's actions against Philippine vessels, as this helps raise awareness among the locals as well as in the international community.
We don't know the threshold kung ano yung malala at kung lalala pa ba. But definitely, I believe the more we expose this kind of aggressive behavior of China, it has a certain impact, no? Not just for the Filipinos to be aware of what's really happening, but more countries now are expressing support to the Philippine government and also criticizing the aggressive behavior of China.
Manila's Foreign Affairs Department has summoned Chinese ambassador to the Philippines, Wang Xilian, following Beijing's latest aggression in the West Philippine Sea. The DFA also raising the possibility of expelling Wang from the country. Over the weekend, Chinese Coast Guard and maritime militia vessels used dangerous maneuvers on Philippine boats conducting a humanitarian and support mission to Ayungin Shoal. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has slammed the incident. He says this only strengthens the government's determination to defend and protect the West Philippine Sea. Marcos asserts Ayungin Shoal is within the Philippines' exclusive economic zone, and any claim of sovereignty by other nations is contrary to international law. The international community rallying behind the Philippines. The U.S. State Department says the incident disregards Filipino safety and international laws. It also reaffirmed America's commitment to the mutual defense treaty between Washington and Manila. The European Union, meanwhile, calls the incident deeply troubling as it called for a peaceful and lawful resolution to the issue. Japan also standing with the Philippines. It says it opposes any actions that undermine peace and stability in the South China Sea. A Philippine congressional panel approves a report urging the National Telecommunications Commission to suspend the franchise of Sunshine Media Network International, or SMNI. The House Legislative Franchises Committee cites SMNI's alleged violations of its franchise. Lawmaker Margarita Nograles, the author of the resolution, says SMNI violated its franchise by publishing false information or willful misrepresentation. The panel also suspends consideration of SMNI anchor Jeffrey Celis's request to be released from detention. This is after Celis's wife and the husband of his co-host, Lorraine Badoy, brought the matter to the Supreme Court. Badoy and Celis were cited in contempt by the House last week for acting disrespectfully and refusing to answer questions on their alleged red tagging and disinformation peddling. Celis previously alleged House Speaker Martin Romualde spent 1.8 billion pesos on his travels. The Philippine Senate approves the government's proposed 5.7 trillion national budget for 2024. Minority Leader Coco Pimentel was alone dissenter of the ratification. The budget measure now awaits ratification by the lower chamber, after which it will be transmitted to Malacanang for President Marcos' signature. The bicameral conference committee approved the reconciled version of the 2024 General Appropriations Act this morning. The Senate Finance Committee chairman notes no confidential and intelligence funds were granted to civilian agencies in the final bicam version. This includes the Office of the Vice President and the Department of Education. Philippine jeepney drivers set to stage yet another transport strike this week over the government's jeepney modernization program. Jackie Manabat now on the line with the details. Jackie?
Jeepney operators and drivers group Piston announced that they will mount a transport strike on December 14 and 15. This date fall on a payday and Christmas rush. Piston said they are confident that they could paralyze the traffic in the National Capital Region with the numbers of their members planning to join the strike. The group expects around 100,000 members to join the strike. Piston's members' route includes major Quezon City thoroughfares such as Commonwealth Avenue and E. Rodriguez. Members from Rizal, Alabang, and Manila are also expected to participate. However, Piston warns that their two-day transport strike may be extended if the government maintains that the consolidation provision under the Public Utility Vehicle Modernization Project remains. The group is asking for the public's understanding as they admit it will impact the traffic flow during the Christmas rush. The government stands on its decision not to move the consolidation deadline beyond December 31, 2023. This provision of consolidating or joining a cooperative is also non-negotiable. LCFRB, or Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board, has yet to issue a statement on this matter. Back to you, Ron.
Jackie Manabat, thanks for that report.